So, now we start. We start with actually the goal. Is everyone's goal same or different? My God, in one voice. Everyone's goal is different.
Same.
He's got discrimination of age.
Happiness.
He's understood. That's why sometimes what happens, we don't take advice of seniors. It happens mostly with children. That's why youngsters of these industries come to me and they say, my father is trying to impose himself. I want to become the chairman of the company and he does not want to give up. He does not want to give up. So I said, till he is there, what is your age? So he said, I'm 28. And when I go, what's your father's age? He said, 60 years. Where did he start business? When he was 25. So when I go, how many years experience does he have? He says 35. When I go, how many years experience do you have? He says, 8 years. When I add 35 with 8. 8 plus 35 is 43. Now, if you take his experience, you get 43 years of experience and your father has got 35. So who's more smarter? This one. Right? So please remember one thing in life. Try adding from other people's experience. So what he said is absolutely right. You don't have two goals in life. Everyone's goal is one. Everyone's goal is one. There are not two goals. Why do you want to become a GM? Why do you want to become a president of a company? Why do you want to open a business? Why? What will it give you? No, it will give you success, but what does success give you? Satisfaction. Satisfaction leads to? So that means the goal is one or two? So that means everyone's goal is?
One.
The biggest mistake we are doing is this, that we are this is not with you. I met people from MIT and Harvard also and I asked them this question. And they answered, they gave me also, but I did ask you because we'll not waste much time. You don't have these same seminars and then full day seminars. We totally ask only questions. You get the total feel of the person. You say, all tests done, blood test, X-ray, MRI. So you know the person completely. So I'll just talk, give you an example. There were two boys, they were the sons of one of the top most sweet meat makers in Bombay. They've got more than 100 shops in Bombay. Plus they've got industries which are supplying to defense and they are monopoly business. So I think that is the best. So the one who was handling the monopoly business of industries has done his MIT and the other one has done his MBA from States. Now I asked them a question. I said, do you know your goal of life? So they said, absolutely clear. We are absolutely clear, no doubts about it. Very good. And then he comes back. He said, without knowing the goal, you are going to be a failure. You are very smart. So I asked him, what do you want in life? What is your goal in life? So this person who is basically the MIT engineer, he says, I want to have 40-50 more industries which are monopoly items. And you are afraid of competition, boy. And you can't remain without competition for a very long time. That's what you must have read in Jet Airways, right? They don't want a union. You can't be without a union for a very long time. 13,000 employees and without a union will not stay for a very long time. We have problems. So, he said, I want more industries with monopoly. Only me there. So, okay, very good. And I asked the boy, the other one who's a management, he was an MBA, he was handling the sweet meat part, the mithai ke dukaan. He was handling the meat, his mithai dukaan thing. So I asked him, what is your goal? He said, I want about 1,000 more shops all over the world. I said, okay, are you clear? Said, yes. Now, take a situation, hypothetical situation, where I tell you your desires will be fulfilled, but with that you will get cancer cold stage. Would you accept it? Hey, we're not interested. Your goal never changes. The meaning of goal is, it never changes. Remember one thing. Let's take an example of a football field. You've got a goalpost, right? Does this goalpost change anytime in the match? It may go from this end to this end, but it remains your opposite every time. You have to score within these two poles, right? So goal never changes in life. That is actually the meaning of goal. If the goal changes, that means it is not the goal. And the moves which you make, the coach which he decides on the moves you make in your life, they are the means. Now these two boys also, what they were talking about were actually the means. They were thinking the means to be the goal. And that means they were not clear about their goal. So you also please remember the goal is one, because all of you, it may be you want happiness to someone said, but he also I think so came up with no different goals. No, goal is one, and that is actually this. Happy end? Why do you want financial security? Because you want to be happy. Why do you want to have emotional security? Because you want to be happy. You want peace. Because, now remember one thing, I'll just give you some small formula. Satisfaction leads to peace, and peace leads to happiness. Now you say, my God, if you are satisfied, this progress stops. Don't worry. Progress does not stop with satisfaction. Satisfaction increases productivity. You say these two things don't match, but I'm going to tell you how. So first it is satisfaction. Satisfaction gives you peace, and peace gives you happiness. This is actually the formula. Today what is happening, we want to jump from here to actually here and here. We want to miss out this far. Is it right? Now, you want to make paneer ki sabzi without paneer. How is it possible? Is it possible? Not possible. You want to make a shirt without cloth? Not possible. Paper shirt is no shirt. So, all of this. Maybe desire fulfillment. Why do you want your desire to be fulfilled? Because you feel satisfied by this. You feel peaceful and you feel happy. Next, discrimination. Why do you discriminate between good and bad? What is good? Then what gives you happiness is good, and the one which gives you suffering is bad. But remember one thing. Sometimes when you struggle, there are some suffering. But that should not deter you, because the ultimate goal is happiness, and you will attain. Remember, sometimes you feel like hearing 2 years of MBA is not going to be a cakewalk. You have to work hard, yes, you have to. And working hard is not every time enjoyable. You have to curb your enjoyment tendencies. Otherwise, you go off track. So, discrimination between good and bad, equality of. We'll take his words only, mind and heart. Why do you want it? It will give you tranquility, right? Satisfaction, peace, and result in happiness. So, everything is in life. Now, we should be clear that whatever we are doing in life, is for one thing. Is so, if you see success means to be happy. Simple.